Evet, buradan şu tünelden şu Gunuskart Hisarı'na gitmeye çalışacağız.
I'm glad Brock and Sindri were able to work out their differences.
Now they are twice as irritating.
Ah, I think it's nice to see them trust each other again.
Now then, that story I started earlier. I was to tell you the story of Hrungnir the Brawler. The old story. Hrungnir, you see, was born with neither head nor heart. So the giants had to complete him with stone. He was strong, to be sure, but also a perfect simpleton. Odin met him wandering in Midgard one day. Found him so amusing, so harmless, so gullible, that he invites him back to his palace in Asgard. There he gives Hrungnir his fill of mead, and goads him into all manner of boasts and antics, all for the amusement of the court. Or I can just tell you the story later. Later.
Bakalım içeride neler var. Evet, buraya da bizim kılıçlarımız olmadan gelsek bir manası da yoktu.
Look here.
Yes, sir. It says, glory to the dwarf king. May his reign be long, prosperous.
Bak bak bak, yine burada bittiler ya.
I'm feeling creative today. I suppose you prefer my brother's work? You're wrong, of course.
Whoa. Look.
Hala kardeşine bir laf sokmaca derdinde.
Kane, I hope we can find the binding shrines. This place is huge.
Yeah.
The Dwarf King captured more than one dragon. He must have needed them to create this legendary armor.
Interesting thought, lad. And it makes sense. Nearly everything about dragons is useful and contains power. Teeth, scales, even excrement.
Excrement?
Shit.
Dragon shit is powerful?
Aye, lad. Totally powerful.
Ned is having fun with you.
Oh, I knew that.
Son of a bitch.
That's an impressive front door. These materials must be pretty special to make a legendary armor.
This legendary armor better be worth the trouble.
But if Brock and Sindri make it together, I'm sure it's worth the effort. Don't you trust them at least?
I trust you, Atreus. I do not trust the legend.
Oh.
Yeah.
Üst katı koyacağız.
Not yet.
Ulan burada şu aşağıya koyacaktık. Bak hata ettik.
Focus up, boy.
Well, that's one entry stone.
Evet, ilk taşı aldık.
Looks like it needs three entry stones. Stone number two. This place is even bigger than Vaderkon.
Yes. The Dwarf King's reach appears vast.
Wonder what happens if it won't open? Looks like we need three. Yeah.
Ready yourself, boy!
Yeah.
ways to find out, but they're rather messy.
I guess it doesn't matter.
You'd think this dragon would be a bit more supportive, seeing how we're trying to feed it.
Ah yes, see their poison. Not a fan.
Quiet head.
There's something up there.
Boy, over here.
Sir.
that one, brother.
Thank you.
Seems like the right thing to do. Mimir, why did the dwarf thing want this armor so badly? What's so special about it?
There are many legends behind the Dvay Grathitar. A suspicious amount of legends, which makes confirming anything about this particular armor difficult. But the one constant among them is the ability of the armor to offer ultimate protection. A useful attribute for an unpopular king, you see.
Yet this plagued land is all that remains of him. This is why you do not trust legends, boy.
What can you trust?
Yourself, your eyes, your instincts. Blind trust in a legend is a gamble, and rarely does it pay off.
If you say so.
Maalesef yukarıda unuttum, bazı şeyler var, onları alacağım.
Here we go. Huh. It's kind of run down in here.
What did you expect?
I don't know. Less ruin, I guess. Maybe the throne room's in better shape.
Another one here.
Star cannon. Wow. That's a lot of arms.
That's fair to say.
Six, seven, eight? Could he shoot four bows at once?
Boy.
Bundan bende vardı.
Do you hear that?
No. What do you hear, boy?
Crying. And screams. Large crowd of people.
Just don't.
They're getting louder. They sound almost like... Hellwalkers!
Bizim oğlan bizden daha cool takılıyor valla.
There's a passage behind this throne.
A secret passage.
Well, wouldn't be a proper throne room without a secret passage.
Signor. was wondering about this. The things you pulled from him. Those must be the three mythical ingredients Brock was talking about.
I can say with utmost certainty that I've never laid eye on a stranger set of objects in my life.
How are Brock and Sindri supposed to build with... whatever they are?
Don't count the dwarves out, lad. They're right pricks, but they're resourceful. They once made an unbreakable chain out of little more than a cat's footstep and bird spit.
That doesn't even make sense.
Prometheus alevi.
That's the legend. If you wanted sense, you shouldn't be talking to a severed head.
Done.